got a couple guys that are on the shot defense. That's where that, like, that underhook will be coming. And they're getting their elbows buried deep. And they feel safe. They're defending it, but they're not scoring.
So right here, I'm going to still bang the shoulder in the back of his neck. I'm trying to remain short with my arm. I'm going to pull him this way. Towards his face. And then I show it up.
Are you saying your guys want to be there?
Like, they're guys taking shots on us and to defend first thing. And their first thing is underhook that side that they're shooting on.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's a good defense.
Right.
Yes, it's hard to score.
Not short offense.
Yeah. It's good defense, because you're staying underneath the guy, you know? And there's a time and place for that, too. Sometimes, 20 seconds left, you know, you're holding on to a major or whatever it is. You don't necessarily need to score, but you want that extra bonus point. So, you stay there, hang there a little bit, move the guy. But when you need to score, you know, it's, you're down 3-2, you got shoots on you. But then you have to have it's caught, you know, I can circle towards it, kind of loosen up a little bit, like I'm going to pancake and then he's going to play down. I can pull. Yeah. That's one. I know there's one where you, like, pancake him and then stuff to him, right? I shoot on him, I get his arm caught, he goes pancake, and then he just taps his head. Back through it over top. You know, a lot of different, I think changing up your pressure. If I'm just here the whole time, I'm trying to pull, Ryan will crowd me, he just continues to gobble up my arm and crowd me. So if I change my pressure into him, he's not going to get pancaked, or if he is, I'm going to pin him. Right? Then he's quite back, and I can pull. You know, so that little push and pull, changing my angles, changing my pressure. I think that helps. I really think weakening his hamstring, that really helps me. Now he starts moving his body. I'm on my feet, and he's on his knees. So that little, you know, moving my feet and circling to the angles, and changing my head, hamstring, that movement, that really helps because that makes that guy react. You know what I mean?
How about flipping it around when you're the bottom guy, stuck underneath?
Yeah, when I'm the bottom guy underneath right away, same thing I said about the collar, I want a really short neck. A really short neck, and I fight my ear to the belly. So we do a ton of this starting on our feet with, like, hand fighting in the beginning of practice. I'll stack Ryan. He's gonna stay on his feet though. So I'm pushing and I'm pulling out of my fake. I stack as soon as I cover his head, he goes short neck. Ear to the belly, and then he's gonna run to the corner out to his offense, right? So he's got me, and I'm shortening my head, and I catch that elbow, whatever side he covers me on, I catch that elbow, and I bump, and then I hustle. I hustle hip to hip, so my foot step to his toe, and then he's covering my head. And I don't really give him, you know, he wants my head straight, so he can pull my neck and control my head. So if I can beat him to that angle, that's gonna really help me. So same thing on the mat. We'll start on our feet so they get that feel, right? And then he pulls me to the mat. Same thing, outside leg up. Like I would go toe to toe. I throw my head in. I'm using my shoulder to bump this off. All right, so kind of keeping your head on a swivel. You know, we do a lot of shot recoveries, right? Because guys have good defense. They're going to get their legs back. So if I was to hit a single, right, I hit a single, he defends it, I immediately switch that angle, right? He down blocked, covered my head. I went elbow, and I bumped him off with my shoulder. All right, so I kind of changed. It could actually be a good offensive position if I think of it that way. I had a guy, my coach at Wisconsin, he was really good at that. He would hit like a half shot, and the guy, he would sprawl on him, he'd cover his head, and then as soon as he covered the head, he'd be coming on the elbow, and he'd kind of like, almost like sucker drag. You know, you guys know a sucker drag, right, where you catch it. It was almost like a bad shot on purpose to get underneath the guy, and then the guy gets over anxious, he grabs you hard, and then you're around the corner, and you're behind him. That makes sense. It was almost like, I move into him, I hit a single, and then I drag out of it. So I'm changing. I mean, that's probably, you know,
what's your high C recovery drill?
High C? Same thing. If it depends, you know, because he's probably going to get his hips squared and he's going to go front head. You know, but this single is a misdirection because I'm going to his left leg and to his right.
To the opposite side.
A high single.
Off that?
Off a high single or?
Off a high crotch to the opposite side.
On his left leg or right leg? Yeah,
his left.
A lefty high crotch?
No, ready shot, lefty sweep.
Okay. So I'm going here.
Yeah.
He
defends. What's your recovery there? He defends. Yep. Your stuff.
Same thing, because he's gonna cover my head on this side.
Right.
Right, so now I'm doing the same thing. See my trail leg?
Okay.
I was here, right?
Yep.
He's defending. He comes front head. I'm doing the same thing. I'm gonna bring my knee just like I would toe to toe. I'm gonna pull out of it. Alright, but that swivel in my shoulder, in my neck. That's how I would come out of that. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
You could peek too.
Yeah.
You know, you're bigger underneath. That's fucking hard. Peek my butt. Alright, guys that are pretty good there. Guys, you can feel, if he's really trying to score, he's going to be moving. He's going to be relaxed. He's going to be moving. If he's just trying to hang on, he's going to be tense. He's just squeezing, right? That could be worse for him. If he's just kind of holding like a double over or a...
If I shoot and he's holding this double over and he's just squeezing, trying to run out the time at the end of the match, that's when I can peek him.
Right? Make sense? If he's relaxed and kind of waiting for me to make a mistake, then if I peek him, he might put me on my back, on my butt, you know?